servicing and in service, let me tell you, you carry it with you. So when you came in the door, the anointing was already on your life. You brought it when you came in. The worship already began. When you woke up this morning and you opened up your eyes and you were able to see and you were able to speak and you took me there before, that's your worship to God. And you can say, thank you, Jesus. I was glad when they said, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. You ought to be excited, man. You ought to have expectation.
Amen.
Some of us got more expectation for the lottery. Come on. You got more expectation for your paycheck. Listen, I'm excited because I know that we are in the river. Come on. And when you're in the river, this thing has to stir up, man. This thing moves. Hallelujah. And I said and I prophesied at the other church that the doors would be open, that when we got into the river, and God is just continuing to be faithful. He's opening up door after door after door. I am just excited. I'm so excited that he woke me up this morning. Praise God. To be here on one more Sunday, I'm excited. Hallelujah. One more day. Because today is the day of salvation. Hallelujah. That's my consolation. For my eyes have seen your salvation. And the Spirit of the Lord is in this place. Hallelujah. I love what the man of God said. He said, I will not leave your presence. He said, God, I will not go any further. He said, your presence is not with me.
Amen.
You can't do church without the presence of God. Listen, there's many churches where you can walk in, but there's no presence. I don't know if you felt it, but man, there was something in the stillness this morning. When you came in and you played, brother, and the Spirit started to move, and you sang your song, and you did your reading, and you did your worship, man, it was just, wow. Stillness. God can do it. God bless you, sister. Nice to see you. Blessings on you. Amen. Amen. So to be here on one more Sunday, that's exciting. And he says, for my eyes have seen your salvation, and the Spirit of the Lord is here, and he has been waiting for you. Let me tell you that the Spirit is moving. The Spirit is on you today. I get joy. I get excited. I get joy when I'm on the way.
Amen.
See, we can't come into the house bringing all that. We got to let that go and come back and say, God, have your way. Hallelujah. When I looked at the text that we were reading in Luke chapter 2, I started to see the work of the priest. And the priests in the temple were divided. They were divided into 24 courses within their assigned classes. From one Sabbath to another, they served according to 1 Chronicles 23, verse 4 through 5. There were 24,000. Think about this. 24,000 priests and priest assistants, 4,000 gatekeepers, and 4,000 musicians in the temple. But yet this man, Simeon, was there at the right time. Anybody else could have ministered. Anybody else could have received a revelation of Jesus Christ. But he was a man full of the Holy Spirit, and he received a revelation of the child of Jesus, just like she read when that baby left inside the belly. Come on. Hallelujah. When Elizabeth had, she said, hi, how you doing? Oh, the baby started jumping inside.
Amen.
That's power.
Yeah.
24 courses. 24 different courses according to their assignments. But not all of these priests were serving at the same day. Any one of these priests could have ministered to Mary. They could have ministered to Jesus. But the Holy Spirit, by divine inspiration, appears in this account to Simeon, directed him by the Holy Spirit. He goes into the temple, hallelujah, because he loves the Lord. And we are told that he was a righteous and a just man. He was a devout man. Man, let me tell you, man, a man that is devout, or a woman in that case, hallelujah, they're people of faith. They're people of God. They're people of relationship. When you're devout, you're all about the relationship of God. And you know what takes the preeminence. When the preeminence comes, it's Jesus Christ. It's Jesus Christ, hallelujah, above, amen. Hallelujah, to the left, to the right, hallelujah. Everywhere I go is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Somebody said, well, why do you always preach on Jesus? I said, well, why are you preaching what you're preaching? Because my Bible tells me Jesus Christ crucified. I don't want to hear about nothing else.
Amen.
And let me tell you this much. You can hear a good sermon, but if Jesus isn't in the sermon, something's wrong with that sermon.
Amen.
That's
You better talk to me, man.
Right.
You better talk to me about Jesus. I need to hear Jesus in there somewhere.
Yeah.
Amen. Because it said that this man Simeon was looking for the consolation of Israel. The consolation is the comfort. The consolation comes after disappointments. Because let me tell you, because of the history of Israel, they faced a lot of disappointments.
Yeah.
Now, I don't have time to really go into the history and break it down for you and unpack it for you. But let me tell you that the consolation comes after disappointments. It comes after losses. The consolation comes to those who have suffered. How many know what it is to be consoled? When you need consolation after you've been going through hell and you've been going through some things in your life. Even right now, they said that the highest rate of suicide is in this season. Some people are checking out before their time. Not to mention those that have over this past month, so many of them have OD'd.
Yeah.
People are checking out, man. This thing is real. Amen. Mm-hmm. Some people, they need consolation. How can you give something you don't have? You need Jesus.
Yeah.
You can't console people on your own, because if you try to console somebody on your own, you'll make yourself sick. And there's a lot of sick people, because people will make you sick. People will put a demand on you and keep drawing from you. And it's like, listen, you're trying to minister and you are empty. I say all the time, you need to be an overflow.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
Jesus is our consolation. Jesus is our Redeemer who has been offered what? Okay, so let's just put it out there. He has been offered once to bear the sins of many. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But when he appears the second time, that's why we are told to watch and pray and set our hope on the grace that is coming upon us. Let me tell you that Jesus is coming back.
Yes.
Hallelujah. See, that should make you excited right there.
Amen.
See, take your temperature. Because if you're lukewarm, you're either hot or you're cold, man.
Yeah,
okay. He said, no. He said, you're cold, you're cold. But if you're hot, come on, somebody. That's fervency.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. We don't know all that we think we know. And then when we think we know, God has to reveal some things to us. And I don't know about you, but God is still revealing some things to me. Amen. I just want to be that much more like a sponge. I want to be able to take what God has given me.
Yes.
Never got to a point where I know. I know. It's not what I know. It's revelation. It's revealed to you. Because you can have the truth before you and not know that the truth is saved. Let me tell you that the truth is in this room. Let me tell you that the Spirit of the Lord is in this room. Let me tell you that Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is our Redeemer.
Amen.
Let me tell you that Jesus Christ is our consolation.
Amen.
Turn to somebody and ask them. Just turn to your neighbor and say, do you need consolation?
You need consolation.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Do you need consolation?
Amen.
Do you need someone to console you? Somebody might need that. Might need a shoulder to cry on this morning. Oh, hallelujah. They said the government was upon his shoulders. Woo, I feel the Holy Spirit. Jesus is my consolation. Jesus is my comfort. Hallelujah. Do you need some sympathy this morning? Some of us, I just need somebody just to listen. I just need somebody to be sympathetic. Well, I love what the word says. It says that Jesus is our high priest.
Amen.
He is able to sympathize with our weaknesses.
Amen.
He's able to do that. He knows those infirmities that have touched you. He was tempted in all things like us, but yet without sin.
Amen.
Let's get it clear.
That's right.
Amen. Without sin. That I can hear Mr. Gentile say, amen. Amen. So when you suffer,
amen,
he suffers. When you cry, he sees, he knows. They said he takes our tears, he takes our tears and he put them in a bottle.
Yeah.
That's powerful. That's in the Psalms. He knows your pain. He knows your bodily sufferings. Because he is our mediator. He is our consolation. That's why you should be motivated. How many of you are motivated for God?
Yes.
How many of you are motivated for things of God?
Hallelujah.
Amen. If you're motivated, then you ought to hold on.
Yes.
You ought not let go. tighten up your grip. Amen. Tighten up to what? To your professional faith.
Amen.
Because you profess Jesus Christ. You say that Jesus is Savior. You say that Jesus is Lord. Everyone that names that name ought to depart from iniquity. Iniquity is your attitude.
Yep.
You're going to sin. Past, present, and future, he covered that.
Amen.
But it's the iniquity part, man. It's the part that you keep doing it, and you know you ought not be doing it.
That's right.
Hold on to your professional faith. The consolation was given to Simeon, and he held salvation in his arms.
Amen.
We have salvation in our arms. Hallelujah. And it's only when you have salvation in your arms can you offer up an arm or a hand to somebody else to lift them up out of a pit. To lift them up, even in this season right now. There are people that are downcast. There are people that are down so low. Simeon had a promise from God. And the Lord said, you're not going to die until you see it. You're not going to see death until you see it. It may be that runaway child. It may be that rebellious son or that rebellious daughter, that drug addicted, alcoholic loved one. You're not, he says, the Lord is saying, I'm going to let them see my salvation. And they may never walk into the church. They may never read a Bible. But they'll look at your example, like Simeon. They'll say, where are you going? You're going to church. Didn't you just go to church? You're going to church on Tuesday nights now? You're going on Thursday? Every time I turn around, that's not normal. You keep going to church. No, what you're doing is not normal.
Amen.
We got it twisted.
That's right. Amen.
The things of God, hallelujah, are different from the things of the world.
Amen.
Amen.